Alright friends, welcome again to another session on problem solving related to triangles. We are doing basic proportionality theorem and its converse and their application in different types of problem solving. Now in this question, it's been given that two triangles ABC and DBC lie on the same side of the base BC. So you can see the figure. I have drawn the figure. BC is the base and two triangles ABC and BCD, right? Or DBC lie on the same side. Now, from a point P on BC, you can see the point P is here. From the point P on BC, PQ is parallel to AB and PR is parallel to BD. Okay, so you can see PQ, this one is parallel to, PQ is parallel to AB. So I can put these arrows here. So PQ is parallel to AB and PR is parallel to BD. So PR is parallel to BD. Okay. Now they meet at AC in Q and DC in R, which is shown in the figure. We have to prove that QR is parallel to AD. Okay. So this is the question. Now approach. Let's talk about the approach we will take. So what should decide our approach? Now clearly there are triangles involved and there are parallel lines involved. Okay, so the moment there are triangles and parallel lines, the first thing which comes to our mind is basic proportionality theorem or the Thales theorem, right? So somehow it is hinting upon that we are going to use BPT or basic proportionality theorem. So we can actually do the reverse. So for example, QR is to be proven to be parallel to AD. Now by converse of BPT, if somehow we prove that, so this is, you know, this is how you should be approaching it. So now I'm doing some kind of analysis here. So they are asking me or us to prove that QR is parallel to AD. Now what we'll do is, let us say that QR is parallel to AD, then what will happen? Then clearly by BPT, we know that if this is true, then CR upon RD must be equal to CQ upon QA. And that means what? If we somehow prove this particular thing, then we know we will lead to this. Correct? So let us say if we can prove CR by RD is equal to CQ by QA, which in a way is there. How? Let us see. Now let me now keep it. So now you know the target. You have to prove that QR is parallel to AD. Now there are rituals. What are the rituals? So ritual is given. What is given? PQ is parallel to AB. Okay. And what is given? PR is also parallel to PR is parallel to BD. Okay, and what is to be proven? So to prove, you write to prove QR is parallel to AD. Okay, and here goes the proof. Okay, how? So what you'll do is, we will write in triangle, see, observe triangle ABC. Okay, in this triangle, PQ is parallel to the third side AB. Right, and we know that by BPT, in that case, what will happen? We will write CP by PB is equal to CQ by QA, and within brackets, you must write by BPT or by Thales theorem. Okay, now you see, observe here, we have got CQ by QA, which is on the right hand side of the desired result, right. So somehow if we prove that CR by RD is also equal to CP by PB here, then we are done. Okay, let's see how. Now in triangle, so I'm writing here itself, in triangle, now we are coming from here to here. Okay, so in triangle CAD, okay, we know that PR is parallel to AD. I'm sorry, not CAD. It is actually CBD. Okay, so not CAD. We are going to deal with CBD. And in CBD, PR is parallel to BD. Okay, so again by BPT, we can write CP upon PB. So this upon this should be equal to this upon that, right? So hence we can write that as CR by RD. Okay, so let us say this was equation number one and this was equation number two. So hence, guys, from one and two, what do we see? We can equate the RHS of 1 and 2 and we can write CQ upon QA is equal to CR upon RD. See, this is the desired thing which we wanted. Here we got the same thing. Now this will imply, this implies what? By converse of BPT, RQ is parallel to AD. Okay, RQ is parallel to AD, and you can write in triangle, which triangle? CAD. Right now, so if you see in this triangle, C, this one, let me draw it from the, you know, C, and then CAD is this, right? CAD is this triangle, and in that triangle, this thing, so basically this side by this side was equal to this side by that side, isn't it? So hence we can say that these two lines are also parallel. Okay, so by application of BPT and by application of converse of BPT, we could prove that the given lines are parallel. So what is the learning, guys? Learning is, we see a triangle and there are discussions on parallel lines. You know what could be probably used, and that's basic proportionality theorem. And with some manipulation with the direct BPT and its converse, we can solve these kind of problems.